When we talk about fall clearance and how to calculate our fall clearance, being able to calculate that clearance properly is really, really important. Let's start with our lanyards. When we calculate fall clearance for our lanyards, we're always calculating from our anchor point. We're not calculating that from our walking surface. So the first thing we have to do when we calculate our fall clearance is we have to know what is the first thing that we could come in contact with. Is that a lower level? Is it the ground? Is it something that may be stacked on the ground that could be the first thing that we come in contact with? We also have to know what the length of the lanyard is that we're using and what the deceleration distance is on that. When we calculate fall clearance using a lanyard, we start at our anchor point. We start with what our maximum free fall would be, which is 6 feet, the length of the lanyard. We go into the deceleration distance on that device, which would be 42 inches, 3.5 feet by OSHA standards. Then we have the distance from the worker's back D-ring to their feet, which on average is probably about 5 feet. Our body's gonna conform into the harness. That back D-ring's going to stretch up about a foot, and then about 2 feet of safety clearance, just in case we calculated correctly or things weren't quite where they needed to be, or we have workers of different weight, brings us to a total of 17.5 feet. So using a standard 6 foot lanyard, we could need a total of 17.5 feet from our anchor point to that next level. That's 6 feet of lanyard, 3.5 feet of deceleration, 6 feet of worker and harness stretch, and our safety clearance at the end for a total of 17.5 feet.